Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome back to Granada, Spain, where we are gathered for the last final of the day, Double Trap Men. I'm Hilary Russell and have the pleasure of having Sweden's 2012 Olympic Games silver medalist Håkan Dahlby here with me today. Welcome, Håkan, and thank you for joining us today.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
So I'd like to know if you wouldn't mind going over the new finals format to explain to the viewers exactly how the semifinal and medal matches work.
Well, I don't know much about this, I have to say, because I haven't been participating in this new finals. So do you know, have you any more information about this?
Well, I can tell you a little bit about it. Obviously, after the qualifications, the top six shooters, and today what happened was we had a three-way shoot-off in order to get into the final. They enter into the semifinal all with a score of zero.
Yes. And the guy who came out as a winner from the shoot-off was Jeffrey Holguin.
And he is from America, so that is a great thing that he got in here today.
And the other two shooters for the shoot-off was Mohsin Vasili and
Al-Dahani.
Mm-hmm. Yes, from Kuwait.
Exactly. So the event consists of a semifinal, a bronze medal match, and a gold medal match. The six shooters shoot rotating from stations 2, 3, and 4. And during the semifinal, a random selection of all schemes A, B, and C will be used in a total of 30 targets or 15 doubles for each shooter or shot. After the semifinal, if there's a tie for 4th, 5th, and 6th place, a sudden death shoot-off will take place, and only from scheme C.
Yes.
And if there's a tie back for 5th and 6th, if there's a tie for 5th and 6th, it's broken by countback.
Mm. And the shooter we will see in the final is, as I said, Jeffrey Holguin, America, Alexander Vavilov from Russia, Hao Wang from China, David Gasparini from Italy, Russell Mark from Australia, and Vitaly Fokiev from Russia.
And in just a couple of minutes, I'll have a chance to officially introduce them as well, and you can give us a little bit of information, a little something on each one of them. That would be great.
Absolutely.
It's been warm here today. It's been a really hot day, so I'm sure that these guys must be pretty tired just from being out there all day long and under the elements. You are covered, more or less, while shooting, but what did you think about the shooting range here?
It's very nice, very beautiful located, and if you come here in the spring, everything is green and nice. You see the target perfectly. Today, it's not that easy, even if the sky, the scores is really high. But the dead grass,
right?
It's tough because it has this more or less the same color as the target.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not an easy range in June, July, August.
No, it isn't. And also, it's been very, very windy here in these last few days. Today, it seems like it's a little bit better.
Much better. Yesterday was a lot of tailwind, so the target was just dropping. Okay. They're not ready. They're just test firing.
Yeah. We'll get this test firing done, and then go into the semifinal. And after the semifinal, we'll have a little break between the semifinal and the bronze medal match. That is, if there is not a shoot-off. And during that time, we're going to have a little conversation with Håkan Dahlby and find out what's new and exciting in your life.
Yes.
But in the meantime, how's your baby?
Oh, fantastic. Last Friday, he just turned 3.
Wow.
And grown a lot. He's 1 meter tall.
Really?
Yeah. 15 kilos. It's fantastic. I don't know. He's going to be a big lad. No, big boy. I don't know if he's going to be a shooter. I think he's going to be golf pro.
Golf pro, okay.
Why not? So he can make some money so daddy can continue to shoot.
Is golf a big thing in Sweden?
Yes.
Is it? Okay.
We have many, many great golfers from Sweden. So yeah, why not? But of course he's going to shoot. I asked him last week. I went down to Crete with my family to spend some days there. And celebrate his birthday.
Nice.
And I asked him, what do you want to be when you grow up? And he said, I'm going to be a dancing shooting star. So why not?
I think that's just great, really.
Yeah.
Well, it's really been a very action-packed day here today. We're not only covering shotgun, but also rifle and pistol, as it's the combined World Cup. And we've already had two of the rifle-pistol events today. And now finally everyone's outside again, except for us. We are
in the sun.
They're in the sun. We are in a nice cool booth with air conditioning, so we're pretty fortunate with that.
Very, very. No, it's tough out there. I mean, standing in the sun, no shadow. It's tough. But I mean, we used to it. All the Olympic finals is shot with no covers.
Right.
Yeah.
But during the qualifications, you did have them.
Did we? Not in London. No, we had no covers.
Okay,
no,
in London, right?
But in Beijing there was covers on station 1 and 3, but not in the center.
Okay. Mm?
So just for spectators.
Right, right. So it looks like we'll have a chance now to introduce our 6 finalists. Once again, there was a 3-way shoot-off to get in, and it was Jeffrey Holguin who won the shoot-off, and it was an insane shoot-off. In fact, it was
56 targets.
56 targets.
Fantastic.
Unbelievable. And that was Aldahini was out after 3.
Yeah.
And Mohsen after 55 and 56 won it for Holguin. So he must be feeling it right now, I think.
I have a very funny story about it. I can take it later. What?
Okay. That'd be great because in position 1, representing the United States of America, we do have Jeffrey Holguin.
Mm. And this guy is fantastic. One of the best shooters they have in the U.S. Shoots for U.S. marksmanship. Unit to go with Glenn and other boys.
Exactly. It's a nice group, actually, a really nice group of guys that shoot for that.
Yeah, I often go there once or twice every year to shoot with them.
Okay.
Yeah, like a sparring partner.
Oh, nice, nice. 56 target shootout to give them a great round of applause. We do have quite a few spectators. You know, I was kind of surprised to see how many people had turned out because of the heat.
Yeah.
And there's no cover for anyone to sit under. So, you know, these are definitely diehard fans that have come to watch.
Yeah.
And here he is once again, Jeffrey Holguin from the United States of America.
Very talented shooter. Didn't make so many medals last year, but this year we were seeing him win again, hopefully.
Then, in position 2, representing the Russian Federation, we have Alexander Vavilov.
Also one of the best Russian shooter. 35 years old, and can I say, it's comparison to Mohsin and Fokiv. He's next up.
In position 3, representing the People's Republic of China, we had Wang Hao. And we don't really know a whole lot about him, so we're going to move on now into position 4. Representing Italy, we have Davide Gasperini.
A very talented Italian shooter. Coming up.
In position 5, representing Australia, we have Russell Mark.
Mm, old man. Won everything.
He certainly has.
Yeah.
And it's really great to see him in the final. He's always so great about coming and commentating with me. And it's nice to be able to be commentating about him right now.
Oh, yeah.
In position 6, representing the Russian Federation, we have Vitaly Fokiv.
Mm. One of my components in Olympics last year.
That's right.
Yeah. Very talented, very good shooter from Russia.
So let's hear the funny story that you've got about Jeffrey Holguin.
Yeah. Oh, we shot the World Cup in Acapulco a couple of years ago. I ended up second place, winning the silver medal. I had a shoot-off with Jeffrey.
I remember this very well. Go ahead and tell it.
And in the shoot-off, we went 2 rounds, and nobody wants to miss the target. And we came into coming to the third. And when I'm over in the States, we normally swap guns with the charges to make it more fun. So we're coming to station 1, and asked Jeffrey, do you want to swap guns? And he said, yes. I turned to the jury or the referee and said, can we do that? And they're like, big no. It's not. So we didn't. And hence he stepped up station 1 and then he shot hit lost and I shot hit. So, well, it's a funny story.
It is a really funny story because I think just that little bit of humor finally broke it because that was a long shoot-off you guys were in. It was, I can't remember if it was like 30-something.
Yeah, it was 3 rounds, 4.
Okay, here we go.
We start. He just shot 56 targets and now he lost 00.
That's right. He must be quite tired right now, I would think.
Yes.
And let's take a look now.
They say you have a tailwind, targets drop in. It's easy to go over with the gun.
Well, the thing is also when you're starting off with zero again, if you've got a double miss, you've got to really, really fight to get that back.
Yeah. I don't know about a lot about this Chinese shooter, but so he had been participating in 99 and 2001 at competitions, but now he's back.
He's
shooting
back, yeah.
Really, really good.
He won the silver in Elaine when we were there in the United Arab Emirates, so we'll have to keep an eye on him. Now back on to Gasparini.
Oh. Yeah. Oops.
And one got away from him
again,
as well.
Dropping target.
Oh!
Oh, another one.
What do you suppose is going on here? Do you think it's
tailwind.
The wind?
Yeah. Tailwind, yeah. And this guy had the same problems in the Olympic final. Oh, and he shot over the first one. Because that dropped from the beginning.
Right. Mm.
So it's tough. Tough start for the shooters. Very tough.
Tough for me, it's a little bit surprising to see. I was expecting to see everybody just starting right off on the right foot. But like you said, with the tailwind and everything, and especially for Jeffrey, who had just shot 56 targets, I mean...
What happens also now is that I don't think they have set the targets properly because the targets we shoot now is a flash target, and they're heavy. So what happens if they don't set the target properly, the heavy target just drops more rapid, not faster than the normal target. So it just flies differently. So this is a problem. Oh, you see another one?
Yeah, another one.
Shoots over because they're heavier. They fly.
Okay, again back on to Russell Mark. Hmm? I would really like to see him win because of all the time and effort he's put in with me and commentating. He's always such a great sport. You're right.
Another lost. Yeah.
Oh!
And another one.
This is very tough. Interesting how this is working out.
Okay,
there we go. Fokiv has hopefully broken this pattern.
Fokiv just also just swapped to a new stock. He's shooting within this new nail grip stock as I'm doing. Back at the Olympics, we were four shooters shooting with this stock. Now more shooters going over to that because it's adjustable. You can adjust everything. And that's good because during the competition, when this thing happens, you can still adjust it. So if the top is dropping, you can go down. The impact, you can lower the impact easy.
Okay.
So that's the good thing. And I hope he knows about that.
So it looks like these guys are kind of getting into it, or maybe they're seeing how the targets are, as you were saying, are heavy, and now they can set their sights on where they think this is going to be coming out and how long it's going to be staying up in the air.
Most of the shooters are really well-experienced, so they know exactly what to do now.
Oh!
Nice.
Oh,
yeah.
Good. Perfect hits. Into Vitaly. Shoots over. Tough.
Yeah, that's a tough one.
Yeah.
We're going to take a look at the standings now and see what's happened after those first three doubles. We have one holding on to first place and 1-2-3-way tie between Fokiv, Gasparini, and Mark. Holguin and Valavov are tied up now for fifth place.
You see the wind's picking up.
Yeah, and it does here. In the afternoon, it really picks up quite a bit. It's cooling down just a little bit, but being underneath the sun like that, I can't imagine that these guys are feeling any great relief.
But must have been tired now, Jeffrey, shooting 56 targets straight.
Yeah, absolutely.
Ball!
Oh, I hit that.
Nice. Very nice.
Sporting shooting. Need to follow the target more.
Okay, Valov also hit that. Mm-hmm. And back on now to Wong, who is currently holding on to first place.
Oh
yeah.
This is something you have to say about the People's Republic of China and their teams. whether it's shotgun, rifle, or pistol, they've got really strong teams. And sometimes you can see them coming in, winning the gold, and then you don't see them again.
No.
You know, so...
There's so many.
There are tons, yeah. Okay, looks like Gasparini just needs a couple more minutes to, or a couple more seconds to regroup. Also, obviously, Italy, you'll almost always see in shotgun an Italian in the final.
It has been DiSpigno and Francesco Daniello for the past 4 or 5 years. And now I think we will see more and more with this Gasparini guy. They have a lot of good... Bernasconi, the old trap shooter.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly.
Second place in Cyprus. They're back. Ah.
Nice. The wind is really picking up, as you can see.
You see also that they shoot with different techniques. Some of them are still shooting high ribs. Another dropping target. Some of them moved the gun with the target from the beginning, from the bunker top. Some of them are putting the gun like before, spot shooting, some of them.
And so why do you suppose that is, that some people choose one way and some people choose the other?
Well, not to make too much change from the old system. So some of them are still putting the gun at the same height and waiting for the target to pass the gun, and then they go for it.
Okay.
He did shoot the 00, was it?
I believe that it was. I think that they both got away from him. I'll have to take another look next time it's on the screen.
No, it's not easy. Not easy at all.
We could have seen Holguin just a couple minutes ago. He was stretching out his back. So, like you said, he's probably very tired.
Yeah.
That's the second one that gets away from one.
Yep. Focusing.
Oh, nice. Good. Very nice. He just had a little bit of a rough start, and now he's definitely on a roll. Whoa. Good.
Excellent. Good pair.
I think Fokiv is really pretty hungry for the gold.
Yeah. I've been watching Vasily for the along this year. He's been shooting fantastic.
Really?
Good scores. But been unlucky. I saw him. He was in an Italian. He shot 142 and didn't win any medal. No. I think it was 142. Ah. Also in Cyprus, he shot 142 and didn't win any medal. But finally, now in Cyprus World Cup, he ended up as a winner. It's not easy because it's too big difference between the leader and the last shooter in the final, coming into the final. And you need just a little bit luck.
You do.
One more target.
Absolutely.
With a new system. I don't like the new finals because they are a little bit too long, a little bit too boring for them. I like the old system a little bit better, and I think also that the right man won. I mean, who hit the most targets? Oh, that was tough.
That was tough. Again, on to Fokiv, and then we're just going to take a look at the standings once again.
Oops, new target.
There's another one that's gotten away from him. Oh, no.
The flash came out.
Okay.
So it's a new target. Good. Just waits a little bit more on the second target. Goes under it and pull the trigger.
So what do we have here? We have got Fokiv and Gasparini tied up, and also Valilov and Wong tied up with 9 each. Mark with 8 and Holguin with 7.
Well, they had a tough start.
Certainly did. Yeah.
with a double miss. Takes it to
over to Hogan again.
Targets. Still a long way to go, though. Nine doubles remain in this semi-final.
Glenn shot good in that lane. Shot 1-4-6.
Yeah.
And didn't get any medal.
I know. Mm. And this is what has been like the dispute.
Oh.
I've been hearing a lot about is, yeah, there's another one that's getting away from Hogwin.
And that's tough. One shooting 1-4-6 and not ending up with a medal, that's tough. And he's been shooting good today also, but it's not in the final.
Well, you know, when you said you go to America sometimes to train with them, it must be a really fun group to hang out with.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean, they are great shooters. Richmond, Holguin, Heller, Habermann, all this. Great guys.
All right, again on to Gasparini. She puts his cheek down so hard on that.
Typically Italian. Like Russian, the same too.
It's true. Yeah.
Oh.
There we go.
Great.
And fuck it. Really, just had a little.
She's reversed. Normally, he shoots left, right. Here he shoots right, left. Okay.
And why would you suppose that has changed?
Because you know exactly what targets is coming. That's another thing. They're calculating.
Oh.
Some of them is writing on a piece of paper. Some of them have a coach standing behind them, telling them what to expect on the next station.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them that keeps them everything in the head.
That must be difficult to keep everything in your head.
Yeah.
Shoot, and do the mathematics behind it.
I keep in mind station 1, 3, and 5, because 2 and 4 is very close.
Okay.
It's tough. Because you know you're going to have an A, B, or C on every station.
Right,
yeah.
Right.
Okay. Do you see when they're swapping places?
Mm-hmm.
So it looks like they are dancing around each other.
This has also been a general consensus lately that people are saying that. Jeez, Gasparini is just shooting like a star. He's doing a great job.
Yes.
Again, on to Russell Mark.
It's not that old, so he has very good eyes. He's 23. Young
doesn't
guy.
Doesn't seem quite fair, does it?
Oh. Next one. Missed one. Shot over. Another dropping target.
Ready. Ball.
Good
shot.
Hogan has gotten back into it again.
Mm-hmm. Oh, another flash. New targets.
Does that bother you when that happens?
No.
No, you're used to it by now.
Not now, because I don't know about his holding points. There, because he lost it. Because he missed both.
Right.
But now when I'm moving with the target, and with this new technique I shoot, and it's no good. But I'm looking at Bernasconi, he moves like a trap shooter.
Right.
So it doesn't matter if he has a holding point. He just put the gun on the bunker roof and moves with the target.
Okay.
But if you have holding points, and this happens, you can't look down, because then you don't know where the holding point is.
Okay.
Yeah, shot well. Over to Russell.
Oh!
Oops. That's one that gets away from Russell. And next on to Fokif. Yeah, you're right. The Russians also put their cheek down very hard.
Very hard.
Okay, let's take again once again a look at the standings and see what we've got.
Lots of change.
Yeah, three-way tie now for first between Fokiv, Gasparini, and Wang. And we have Valilov in fourth place. Hogwin is in fifth now, tied up with Russell Mark.
Yeah. Russell has been struggling a little bit now. Let's see if we can pick up. He's so experienced.
It's amazingly experienced, yeah.
Yeah. But it's tough also coming now. I don't know. If you look at it's still it's good delight.
Mm-hmm.
But coming up in our age, it's tough, especially when the shadows are coming, normally at this hour.
Right.
But here's, the sun is okay, you see the target good. When the shadows are coming, and it's tough to see the target sometimes.
And you were saying, against this grass, it's really difficult to see them, huh?
Yes, because the color is very similar to the background, you see?
Yeah.
It's hardly you can see. You can see them in the sky.
Right.
It's tough to see them against the green, the yellow background, the dead grass.
Okay, let's take a look now at Gasparini, who's shooting just a really, really fantastic semifinal.
You see, nice. He shoots moving target, moving gun. He moves with the target.
Right.
Mm. Oh!
There's another one that's getting away from wrestler Mark, and you can see on his face, he's not really quite pleased with that.
No.
Whoa.
Oops.
And they both get away from Fokiv.
Yeah. Ready. Tough. Over.
Ball.
Seems like Holguin's kind of getting back into a rhythm there.
Mm-hmm.
With that said, I don't want to jinx him, and I'll just leave it at that.
Good. Look at the Chinese shooter.
Oh.
Nice.
Very nice shooting.
He followed that second target really nice.
Now the way that you shoot, are you following it?
No, yeah. But I've changed everything. New technique, new barrel, new rib.
I'm
shooting the same as Gasparini MX 2003. So I changed, made a new stock, new barrel, everything. So it's everything is brand new.
How long does that take to get used to?
Well, I haven't been shooting so much this year, but takes a while. Yeah, especially if you're gonna train a new technique also, because I'm a spot shooter.
Mm-hmm.
It takes a long time to get used to the new technique, but let's see. I'm going to see if I can find a new coach that can teach me how to shoot again.
Well, so I wish you the best for that, because I want you around for a while.
Thank you.
Ball!
Nice.
Good. Well shot.
Ah. Not a lot.
There was, I think he was swearing there.
I think. Like, Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Nice.
Yeah.
Very nice. You see, he know exactly what you're going to shoot an A program there, because he put the gun on the station A.
Right.
On this machine number 7. So they keep in mind what target's going to come now. You don't know the first 5 stands, but then you can calculate.
Then you can okay.
Oh.
Yeah, 3 stands.
Gasparini is still shooting strong.
Very.
Oh!
No, he got them both.
Hit that, yeah.
And on to Fokiv. Okay, good. Seems like he's getting back into the groove here. And we'll take a look once again at the standings to see what's going on here.
David Gasparini here, 21, Hao Wang, 21, Vitaly and Jeffrey on 18, Alexander and Russell on 17.
Now we've got 3 more doubles, and then we're going to find out who's going to be going into the bronze medal match and the gold medal match.
Looking good for Gasparini.
It is. Mm-hmm. And actually, Holguin, who had a really rough start of it, you know, he's holding on to a pretty good position there, at least for... You know, perhaps to duel it out for the bronze, but you never know what's going to happen in these next 3 doubles. I have a feeling that Wong is going to maintain where he is, and also Gasparini. The two of them are just shooting too well.
Oh, great. Very nice.
Vavilov. Opportunities.
Oh. Gun's going over top. Tough targets, the ones that are dropping. It's one of the hardest targets to shoot, the one, because you only see the small, you see the target going from you.
Mm-hmm.
You don't see them when you're going up to the top. You have to shoot just beneath it. But when the target is dropping and your swing is going up, you're just passing it, and you shoot the target, the shot's over. It's really, really tough, really hard to shoot.
Oh!
It's much easier to shoot a crossing target than a target going from you.
Right. Mm. And Russell Mark has got emotion written all over his face today. Okay, again, on to Holguin. Holguin seems like he's gotten into a routine, you know, more of a rhythm of his own.
Mm. He always, when he mounts the gun, exactly the same way every mm-hmm. time.
Oh, you could see that was a no target there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's the only double trophy shooter I know who's doing this routine. Because Ella and Richmond doesn't mm-hmm. do it.
Nope.
No.
Okay.
Nice. Okay, the Chinese. Let's see.
Oh,
just over the top.
Ready.
Just over the top.
Gasparini getting ready, and I don't think, I'm not sure. I guess we'll have to wait for the last double to find out. But
no, he knows what kind of is coming out. Yeah, shoots very nice.
Mm. Oh!
Another one over the top.
And Fokiv. Okay, last double, and good old Hockendahl be sitting next to me taking some very deep breaths. Okay, last double for Holguin.
Ball.
Nice,
great.
Really nice. Had a little bit of a rough start, but really got into a groove, and we'll definitely be going into the bronze medal match. Mm. There we go. Again, onto Wang.
See. Oh. Oh, good.
Nice, a nice way to finish up.
Great score.
Ready.
In this weather condition, 26 is very good.
And Gasparini, he definitely has a signature pre-shot routine that he goes through.
Great.
Really nice way to finish up.
Oh!
Oh,
that's too bad. Nice also to finish up. Getting that, and let's take a look and see who is going to be going in. I believe it is definitely going to be Gasparini and Wang going in for the gold medal match.
Yes.
So, ladies and gentlemen, at the end of
Jeffrey and Vitaly
will be going in for the bronze medal match, which we're going to kick off in just a couple of minutes. So there are no ties, and unfortunately, we'll have to say goodbye
to Russell
Mark. great sportsman that he is.
And Vavilov.
Yes, and Alexander Vavilov.
I like to see, because he's shooting really, really nicely.
Mm-hmm.
Really nice when watching him. It's a typically Russian style.
Right, right.
He's one of the guys who can shoot a high score when it's not like perfect conditions. But today, no, he wasn't at his best.
Right, right. No? So let's just talk for a second now about your life, Håkan, and what's been happening this past winter with you.
Oh, a lot of things happened. I did a lot of commercial things like advertisement for my sponsors when after Olympics, and for magazines, TV. And then I did participate in a really, really funny TV show called Dancing with the Stars. It's called Let's Dance in Sweden.
Mm-hmm.
So they called me in February and asked me if I want to participate, and I said yes. So I did 10 dances, 8 dances, 10 weeks.
Okay.
Yep. And
what type of dance do you do?
The first one was Slow Fox, and then we had waltz, we did a rumba, we had full. We won the Paso Doble.
Mm-hmm.
And rumba and Paso Doble was one of my favorite dances. Tango, bug. It's like the quick step.
Yeah, okay.
So, yeah, fantastic. I enjoyed every second.
That is really great. And I love the fact that you mix shooting and dancing. It's just great.
Totally different.
So let's take a look at our bronze medal match. Contenders, we've got Jeffrey Holguin from the United States of America.
And Vitaly Fokke from Russia.
Who would you put your money on, my dear?
Jeffrey Holguin.
Yeah.
Yes. Vitaly, I know that he has problems with dropping targets.
Okay.
I saw that in the Olympic final, and that's why I didn't take in a medal.
Right.
Because there was dropping targets, and I did adjust my stock just before the final because I saw the targets were tough.
Mm-hmm.
And I think Jeffrey is a better shooter on the dropping targets, maybe. Well, we see that. He's been shooting very nicely here.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You know, he did the whole qualifications, then he did 56 targets for a shoot-off.
Mm.
Now he's in the semifinal. Now he's going into the bronze medal match. How do you think he's feeling right about now?
Well, Jeffrey, I think he's calm. He knows exactly what to do. And he knows the targets. And I think it's going to be perfect for him.
But I think he's going to sleep really well tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. I think they're going out partying with the boys.
Yeah.
I don't think they're going to sleep at all.
Good old USA.
Yeah. Let's watch him.
Yeah.
See. Smashing targets.
So once again, they started off with 0. Oh. And we'll have 15 doubles. Nice start.
Mm-hmm. We'll see Vitaly. Oops. Oh, that was a good shot.
That was a really good shot.
Yeah.
Ball.
The last time that Jeffrey won a World Cup medal was back in 2010. So I'm pretty sure that he's ready for a medal.
Absolutely. See, maybe I said too much about Vitaly Fokke not kind of shooting on dropping targets.
That's right.
Mm. Sorry about that. Vitaly, I like him very much.
Be careful tonight. Be careful.
I don't think the Russians is not staying at the same hotel
okay,
as I do.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
Oh, good. That's a tough target.
A really great start for Jeffrey Holguin.
They have a very good coach.
Yeah.
Dan Carlisle.
Mm-hmm.
He's been teaching them a lot about sporting shooting, so they shoot every target by itself, not like before.
Mm-hmm.
So they change also the routine and where to put the eyes on the target. So it's differently.
Looks like one of the referees is speaking, or the jury member is speaking to Hoagland right now. Not quite sure.
What happened?
No idea. Even the interruption from the referee did not take him off course by any means.
Very nice.
These guys are making it look easy now.
Oh, yeah.
The semifinal was a little bit painful, and now all of a sudden things are coming around.
Maybe he did adjust his stock. Maybe.
Could be. Yeah, exactly.
Ball.
Oh, great.
And that's the first miss that we've got, and that's from Fokiv.
With the gun just over the top. Wonder what the referee told Jeffrey.
I don't know, but I'm going to have to ask him after this.
Ball.
Is that a miss also? Yeah.
Just over the top. Good.
There we go.
Back in the game.
Back in the game. And we both gentlemen tied up 11. And
shooting very nicely.
Absolutely. Very, very nicely. But a single miss from him means it remains a tie in this bronze medal match. Also, you got to understand that they know exactly where they're standing. They would know probably anyways from doing the math in their head, but there is someone there that is doing announcements on the PA. So they do know exactly where they're at. And that can add a little bit of pressure, I would think.
Absolutely. What do you think about that?
I think that after the game, I thought it was great during the Olympic Games, you know, because it got the audience really going. I can't really make a comment on it because I don't know how that would affect me shooting.
I was so focused I couldn't hear anything.
Yeah, I'm sure.
I'm just focusing on my shooting. I didn't hear the commentating. No.
Nothing. No.
That's true.
Well, actually, during the Olympic Games, that was not happening. They were just doing the presentation before.
Okay.
And then after, but not during. So it wasn't after every shot or every station that you'd hear where you're standing. Now they are. And this is something that we've had rifle and pistol for a couple of years now. Oops. And there's a miss from Hoagland.
No, because I didn't hear that. So maybe I went gone deaf.
No.
Because I didn't hear that during the Olympics. Nice shot.
No, there was Jack Jay there down in the shotgun range in the Olympics, and he was getting the spectators really riled up.
Okay.
And then at the end, it was another announcer who was saying what the deal was and who was winning and who had won, and so it was really pretty interesting to see the whole thing.
Because I got in really good mood because one of my best friends, DJ, made the music they played before the final.
A friend of yours did that?
Made the remix.
Oh, cool.
Barbara Streisand.
Yeah?
Barbara Streisand.
Yeah.
And Duck Sauce is called. And I know the DJ who did it. So I went in a very good mood.
Oh.
I was in a good very good mood. Yeah.
That is great. All right, we still have a tie here. 16-16. We've got the USA shooting team up there on the balcony watching over their very own Jeffrey Hoagland.
Mm-hmm. See what's... Oh, yeah. It tied again.
Ball.
Great shot. They shoot much, much better now.
Absolutely. Mm. I'm going to have to ask them what happened after, the semifinal. We'll have to see what happens also with Gasparini and Wong, although those guys are shooting fantastically.
Ball.
It was a
Holguin is protesting this.
What, for a new target, or? Because I didn't see that.
No.
Ah! Oh!
I don't know what happened.
See, it's really hard to say from here.
Back it up and give him a new target?
Let's see. There's a lot of discussion here, and Holguin is just trying to get his point across. Yes.
Yeah, they give him a... No? I have to give him a new target. No.
No, they're not. They're not going to do it. Folkiev is definitely taking advantage of that miss.
Ready.
Well, we're going to have to see what's going to happen in that last four doubles here. Anything can happen. Things have been happening, but these guys have been shooting really, really well.
Absolutely. In this weather condition, everything can happen.
Oh!
Yeah, that's more like it.
Yeah, good.
Really, really great shooting. Nice. So now we've got Folkiev in the advantage over Holguin with only three doubles left. What do you suppose is going to happen? What would you put your money on now?
I did put my money on Jeffrey.
You sure did. Mm-hmm. Oops.
So we'll see. Wow. I have no idea.
It's really hard to say.
Stop. Both look so focused.
Absolutely, with precision every single time.
That's his trigger.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh.
Nice.
Good. Very nice.
And you can see how fast the powder from the targets is going right off our monitor here. It's really, really gusty.
Really. Oh, nice. So, because now they know what type of targets they're going to get. So they will place the gun just over the bunker top where the first target they're going to shoot the first target.
Right.
Mm.
Seems to be distracted by something. This is the second time that he's been turning around and looking over his shoulder.
Is it a speaker? He's waiting for the commentator.
It could be. It could be. Absolutely. No, it wasn't.
No?
No, because it's after the third double that they commentate.
Oh, come on.
Ah!
Wow.
Good. So, it's after the last... Pair now.
Last pair, and the pressure's on definitely Holguin to just keep up what he's been doing and clear the pair.
No, the pressure is on Vitaly.
Well, it will be. And, man, if they do happen to go into a shoot-off, we're probably going to have to scrape Holguin off the ground by the end of it.
Another 56 targets. Mm-hmm. Oh, we dropped that.
We did.
Okay.
So, yeah.
It's going to hit one.
Just one, and the bombs will be his.
Yeah,
and he did it
very
both.
Nice.
Very, very nice Vitaly Fokleev from the Russian Federation winning the bronze medal today. Great shooting. I know that he looked frustrated during the semifinal, but he is going to be going home. He's going to be on the podium this afternoon. And we're going to move on now to the gold medal match. Here he is, Jeffrey Holguin from the United States of America, finishing off in fourth place. You know, after a 56 target
shoot off
after qualifications, my hat goes off to him completely.
Fantastic.
Really great. Yeah,
I got tired there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Now, Håkon, while we're waiting for the gold medal match, can you talk to us a little bit about what's going on with your eye?
Well, earlier this season, I had some problems with the new technique and to get everything set for the new discipline, and I did find that. Even though I changed my stock to the new technique, I couldn't shoot the target as I normally do.
Mm-hmm.
So that was something that bothered me. And for a couple of weeks ago, I found out that was my left eye is taken over. I'm normally a right eye dominated,
mm-hmm.
but now my left eye is taken over more and more. So now this competition I've been shooting with a one eye closed.
Okay.
And that's tough. If you were normally a two-eyed shooter,
right.
It's tough to close one and try to shoot as you normally do.
So you've been shutting your left eye during the qualifications today?
The whole competition today.
Oh, dear.
And well, that's why I didn't shoot well in Cyprus and I'm here.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. So I'm going back now to a doctor.
Okay.
Eye doctor.
Hopefully
we can
figure this
out. See if we
can
fix it.
Good.
Yeah.
And here they are, the two gentlemen that are going to be going into the gold medal match. We have Wong and Gasparini.
Yes. And I'm not going to put any money on this.
I'm not either. That scares me.
I would like to see that Gasparini, because he's so young and so talented, and it's good for the Italian shooting, because they have so many great shooters there. And But if I'm going to put money on some shooters here, I would like to have Gasparini as a gold medalist.
All right.
Mm?
You know, he has won a bronze this year in Elaine. And as I was saying before, that Wong has won the silver in Elaine.
Oh, you see, first shot missed. Or the second shot, he did shoot over the second shot. Gasparini, I've been in finals with him and won over him. But that was because... Oh, same. Shooting over the top. No, he's very talented, but he was so young. I met him in a finals in Malta Grand Prix.
Okay.
So we had a shoot off there, and I win. But it's that was the old system.
Yeah, he's only 23 years old. I mean, he's a young'un.
Oh yeah, and they have many more in Italy.
Yeah. Oh yeah, they do. Italy has got a really fantastic team, and they just keep on pumping out one after another.
Mirko has a nice job there.
Okay, no, he's not. Wong, who is protesting.
Well, that was no peace. Sorry. I didn't see that. No. Did he get it? No. He shot over that one. Well, you can try. Yes, he got the new target.
Excellent.
He's getting a new target. Oh. How is this? Okay. That's something
new.
Well,
they must have seen something.
Hmm. Maybe they saw some powder coming out from the bunker. Maybe. Yeah. I didn't see that. Okay.
Okay, anyway, we're back on now to Wong. What's the benefit of shooting with gloves?
I don't know about the right glove, but the left one, you have a... Oh, it was a double zero.
That certainly was. Whoa.
You get a good grip of the gun, especially when it's hot like this. Your hand's getting sweaty.
Right.
And no good grip. So that's why we're shooting with leather gloves.
Okay.
It's like a golf club.
Mm-hmm.
A golf club.
Right. Yeah. Right. So Gasparini now has a 2-hit lead over Wong.
Mm-hmm.
But we still have a ways to go.
Oh, long way.
A long way.
What can happen? Been there, done that. Yes.
Okay, one coming off that double miss right now.
Typically Chinese style.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Is that method?
Was that a no? Nope. It was a hit.
Oh. Beautiful. Oh, great.
Very
really
nice.
Beautiful.
He moves so nice with the target. I remember the Chinese, when we were starting to spot shoot 2004, mm-hmm. they had a lot of Chinese shooters. The coach, the little, I don't know the name is, but he was standing behind us and filming us every movement we did. So he could go back to China and tell all the shooters that you have to do like this.
No kidding.
Yeah, it was, yeah. And they did. It was like copy. They just copy everything. The same height of the ribs, same length of the barrel, same technique.
Unbelievable.
And if you look at Wang Nan and Li Bu, all this, they just copied it. And they shoot exactly the same as we did.
That's amazing.
Yeah. And the rest, all the room shot the same type of gun. High rib.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
But this guy, he can shoot.
Yeah, he can.
Yeah.
Oh.
Very nice.
Gasparini still now has a 2-target advantage over Wong.
Good eyes.
Yeah.
Young.
I know, I was talking about eyes. There's Miracle.
Mm-hmm.
It's
he has a good team.
Yeah.
I haven't seen Francesco Daniello for a long time.
I haven't
either.
Despino
has been shooting good.
Despino, I've seen, he's been doing a great job. But
did he win in Acapulco? He did.
I think yes. That he did. Yeah.
Yes.
Yep.
So he's been shooting good.
It's another miss there for Wong.
Oh.
Nice.
Beautiful.
Very nice.
He looks. There's oftentimes when I'm watching you all shooting. Mm-hmm. Because if we have these cameras that can take the image of your faces, there's a certain click that seems like it happens, and then you just know that the shooter is in the groove completely.
Mm. Yeah.
And that's always so scary when you go into a shoot-off and you think, uh-oh, they're in
that's
it. Both of them are in the groove. We're going to be sitting here for another 20 minutes.
Oh, just over the top. Did he? Yeah. Shut that. Just over.
Oh,
beautiful.
That's what I thought or thinking about when I went into the Olympic final. I said, I'm the only one here who's been to an Olympic final before. And I know that the other ones is going to shit themselves. Because, why not? I mean, because they're scared.
Right.
Scared, yeah?
Yeah, of course. Yeah,
but Peter, he shot brilliant.
Oh.
He shot brilliant. But he was scared in the end. He made a double zero.
Yeah, that's
just 4 targets or 4 doubles from the
end. That was. I wish you could have heard the people in the stands.
Yeah,
it was a huge collective breath of.
Yeah.
No.
And he told me in the press conference afterwards, how can if the round has been going on for another 4 or 5 doubles, you never know.
Oh, that's right. That is absolutely right. Okay, we've got Gasparini still with a 4-target lead. And we only have 6 more doubles to go.
Mm-hmm.
I think he can pull it off.
6 doubles remaining.
Worth my money today, yeah.
Yeah. Great. Signature pre-routine setup there.
Mm-hmm.
kind of touching his vest and his shirt and.
Oh. Trigger. Oh, nice. Very nice. Drop this. Another dropping target.
Okay, you were, second. The second time in the Olympics, right?
Yeah.
But were you nervous when you were walking onto the field of play?
No.
You really weren't?
No, full of confidence. Because shooting the qualification was gray, rainy, windy. I didn't see the target good.
Mm-hmm.
But then, slap, going into the final.
Yeah.
Did he miss one?
He did.
Yeah, I did. And the sky just opened.
Yeah.
Blue sky, sun, and instead of having small targets, tiny ones, it was like big ones. I couldn't. I can't miss them. I didn't find the right color of my glasses also. So I was full of confidence.
But even with all those people watching you?
I was in my own bubble.
Okay.
Yeah. With all this good music playing also, good mood.
Okay.
Shooting is all about feeling.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Good in, like you say, groove.
Yeah.
Good feeling.
There's a miss again.
And don't think about what you have to do. It's just your routine.
Right.
Yeah. Performance.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing else. This is just what Gasparin is doing now. He's doing his performance.
He's just doing a beautiful job. 6 target advantage now. Basically,
very
he just
nice.
Has to hit one more.
Yeah.
And he's won the gold.
Mm-hmm. Single miss, giving him a score
of
22. Well, he will.
Of course, he will. Over one has 16, a pretty much unsurpassable
amount now as we go into the final. Happy for me. Doubles to decide the gold medal. And happy for David.
Yeah.
But this Hao Wang, I mean,
he's
been shooting fantastic.
He has absolutely no lenses in.
No. Just sidebinders.
Mm-hmm.
Another one.
He's having a tough time.
Mm.
Just one hit and...
We have a medal.
We've got a medal.
Yeah, the gold.
Nice.
Oh, yes.
And there you
Very
go.
Nice.
The gold medal is Davide Gasparini.
From Italy.
From Italy, that's right.
This sunny day in Granada, 2013.
We're going to finish this off with Wang and Gasparini. Gasparini has won the gold. There you go. Now he's getting into it. It would be really nice if he could finish off with a clean slate here.
Oh, nice.
Beautiful.
Very nice. Just followed that target perfectly.
Mm. Well, obviously, this is one young man we're going to have to keep our eyes on in the future.
Mm. This is one of them.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. There are a lot of them out there. Last double for Wang Hao, the People's Republic of China. And the silver medal is his. And he unfortunately finished off with a miss, but
the
silver will be his, which is great.
Gasparini winning the gold.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Two smoking
Beautiful.
Hits. Perfectly, perfectly. He's so happy.
Very, very happy.
Yes.
Great work. Oh, fantastic work. And oh, good old Mirko. He's very, very pleased for Gasparini. God, Håkan, thank you very, very much for joining me today.
Thank you.
There he is once again.
For letting me sit here with you and watching all these fantastic shooters performing in the new discipline, double trap.
That's right. Our silver medalist here, Wang Hao from the People's Republic of China. Also, he shot a really, really fantastic semifinal. A little bit of a glitch during the gold medal match, but hey, he's going home with the silver, and that's just great. So I wish you the best of luck for whatever's going to come up for you in the next few months.
Yes.
And take good care of your eye.
I will.
And take good care of yourself.
And do you want to dance? Let's go dance. Yeah. Okay. Bye-bye, everybody.
Okay, bye, everybody. Stay tuned in tomorrow. We've got a couple events taking place here in the finals hall for Rifle and Pistol. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the medals will be presented by Mr. Medhat Wadan, ISSF Vice President and the Shotgun Chairman of a jury appeal for the 2013 World Cup in Granada. He is accompanied by Mr. Guame Bujigas Artigues, member of the jury here at the 2013 World Cup Granada. Your bronze medalist, representing the Russian Federation, Vitaly Fokiev. Silver medalist representing the People's Republic of China, Wang Hao. Your gold medalist representing Italy, Davide Gasparini. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Italy.